Hi everyone, welcome back to these processes from the Project Management Body of Knowledge. Today we're looking at monitoring the risks in our project. And as you can see, if we're monitoring and controlling something, there's a good chance we're in the monitoring and controlling process group. We've been through initiating, we've planned our project, we've executed and created the deliverables, and now we need to keep them under control and make sure that everything is tracking as we had planned. And that includes the knowledge area of risk management. We need to make sure that those risks are monitored and kept under control. Monitoring the risks is the process of monitoring the implementation of agreed upon risk response plans, tracking those identified risks, identifying and analyzing new risks, and evaluating risk process effectiveness throughout the project. How are the risk responses tracking? Are they doing the things that we wanted them to do? Are they having the effect that we wanted them to have? The key benefit of this process is it enables the project decisions to be based on current information about the overall project risk exposure and individual project risks. So we're not just implementing it once and then forgetting about it. We're actually saying, okay, let's check in on it. Let's check in on it again. Let's monitor and control those risks, making sure that we have the most up-to-date information on how they're going. Inputs, tools and techniques, and outputs for monitoring risks. We've got our project management plan as always. The project documents, work performance data, so the raw data about activities or risks that we might have. And of course, our work performance report. So the data is turned into a nice report that can go up to executives or project stakeholders or project sponsors. Data analysis will be our tool and technique, audits that might happen, and meetings. And outputs that we'll see are work performance information, where we're looking at what we had planned versus what is actually happening and how are we tracking, because now we are trying to monitor and control it, so we need to know these two things. And change requests, if we need to make a change to bring the project back on track. Project management plan updates, project documents updates, and organizational process assets updates as well. Monitoring risks can have that input into perform integrated change control because we might need to make a change to one of our baseline documents. And of course, monitor and control project work because we're looking at project information to see how our project is tracking, what we had planned, what's actually happening. Project documents and project management plan are also a key output of monitoring risks. Here's an overview of monitoring our risks. This process uses performance information generated during the project execution to determine if implemented risk responses have been effective. Are they doing what we wanted? The level of overall project risk, is it still within our risk, you know, what we wanted to do for our risk stakeholders? Is it within their threshold of risk? Is the risk acceptable for these people? So has the overall level of risk changed? The status of identified individual project risks, has that changed? Any new additional risks? Any project assumptions, have they changed or are they still valid? And the project strategy, is the project strategy still valid based on the risks that have happened? Project management plan as a key input. So we're going to need the risk management plan because that was our process of how we're gathering, managing and monitoring our risks. It's the framework that we agreed upon at the beginning. And so this is what we're using now as a guide for going through monitoring risks. So this provides guidance on when risks should be reviewed, which policies and procedures should be followed. So do we have any in mind? Are there any existing within the organization? The roles and responsibilities of the people in the monitoring process. And any reporting formats. So how are we reporting on these risks to our stakeholders? Other key inputs will be our project documents. So we may need lessons learned from other projects, our risk register, which is our list of risks that we found, and any previous risk reports that we've shown to other people or our stakeholders as well. Inputs we may need as work performance data. The raw data, as we know, data turns into information, and information can be turned into reports. And so now we're looking at just the raw data. And this is the risk responses, which ones have been implemented, risks that have occurred, and risks that are currently active, and maybe ones that have been closed out as well. This is just pure factual information, and eventually we'll look at turning this into comparison information. So information, and then that can go into reports. Which brings us to work performance reports, because we're going to need to know what has been sent previously to our stakeholders. So we might have variance analysis, earned value data. So all of these combinations of things comparing the current versus actual performance, and any forecasting based on that. Are we looking to continue up? Are we trying to bring the risks back on track? This information can be relevant when monitoring performance related risks. Tools and techniques that we'll see for monitoring risks are data analysis, because we need to analyze that data. Technical performance analysis and reserve analysis. Do we have enough contingency reserves within our cost baseline, as you recall? And do we need any extra management reserves, which is the amount that we add on top of our cost baseline in the event of any unknown unknowns? So any risks that we haven't planned for. Audits may come about as well. So risk audits are a type of audit that may be used to consider the effectiveness of the risk management process. Are we following the right process as we go along on our risk management journey? The project manager is responsible for ensuring that the risk audits are performed at an appropriate frequency as defined in our risk management plan. So this is a key thing that we can place in our risk management plan. Who needs to audit our processes and are they effective? Risk audits may be included during routine review meetings. For example, in Agile, a retrospective, we could say, is risk traveling well? Is it not traveling well? And then we can put that back into our process and improve as we go along. Or the team may choose to hold separate risk audit meetings themselves. That brings us to meetings, which as usual ties a lot of these things together. Risk review meetings may result in identification of new project risks, reassessment of current risks. Maybe they've been brought under control, or maybe they're going out of control. The closing of risks that are now outdated and we don't need to worry about them anymore. Any issues that have occurred, and identification of any lessons for our lessons learned register. Key outputs for monitoring risks will be our work performance information. Now, this includes information on how project risk management is performing. And to do that, we compare the individual risks that have occurred with the expectation of how they would occur. So what did we say at the beginning? Did we say it had a high likelihood of probability of occurring? But now that we've actually implemented a lot of these things or the deliverables, what actually happened? Maybe it only had a 2 out of 5 probability of occurring. And so now we can look at that information and we can say, well, this was actually better performing than we had expected. Because of that, we may need change requests, of course. And this is if a change needs to happen to the cost or schedule baselines or other components of the project management plan. Change requests are processed for review and disposition through our Perform Integrated Change Control process, as we know. In Project Integration Management 4.6, that change request thing comes up all the time if we do need to make any changes to the baseline documents. And that can include recommended corrective action, preventative action, or anything to address the current level of overall project risk. If it's not acceptable to our stakeholders, maybe we need to bring that back on track, and that will affect our schedule or our cost or our scope. Project management plan updates. Any component of the project management plan could be updated because of this. It's also a baselines document and it will need to go through that change request process. But any part of that for our scope, our quality might change, schedule, cost, all of these things might change, stakeholders might change, all of these parts of the project management plan might change and needs to go through the proper process. Project document updates that we'll see are our issue log, if we have any issues that need to be raised, lessons learned, the risk register, if we're adjusting any risks or adding any risks, and our risk report, so that we can send the most up-to-date information on our risks out to our project stakeholders. And of course, lastly, organizational process assets, where we might need to update templates for the risk management plan, if we're adjusting those within the organization, the risk register itself, or templates for the risk report. And of course, the risk breakdown structure, we might be adding categories. So now we have additional risk categories that can go back into the organizational process assets. And those are all the details for monitoring the risks as part of the project management body of knowledge.